I was having y'all about Rico coming with some NFL news today. The draft will be held in a public space. It will not be virtual for 2021. And I want to dive into a lot of the details as to where it's going to be, exactly what it's supposed to look like. There's concept art and everything, there's renderings, when it's going down, everything that fans can do while they're there, because they will allow fans. So we're going to get into all of that soon. Let's get it. All right, so first of all, the main stage of the NFL draft will be right in front of Lake Erie in Cleveland, Ohio. It will be right in between the First Energy Stadium and the Great Lakes Science Center. And then underneath the dome of the stage, there will be a draft theater. And then there will be the seating area for invited guests like players and family. And then there's going to be an inner circle for selected fans. It's crazy because I thought we were going to have at least more than one draft that was going to be virtual, because that virtual one was a little weird with Roger Goodell sitting in his office area, whatever that was. Wasn't really digging that. But some of the interactions with the players and their family, like CeeDee Lamb with the girlfriend and the phone and all of that was pretty entertaining. But having a draft live where people can be there, you can hear people celebrate their picks and things like that, definitely does add an extra layer of atmosphere to even us viewing it from the television or computers, phones, laptops, whatever. You know, technology is different now. I don't think too many people are actually watching the draft on TV anymore, at least not a large percentage. But we're finally going back to a live draft with fans there, with their energy, their passion. And I mean, we'll get some boos if the picks are bad. We'll get some hoorays if the picks are good. And as you may know, the draft is always a 3-day event. It will go from April 29th with round one, then April 30th with rounds 2 and 3, and then May 1st, rounds 4 through 7. But even beyond just like the actual draft, there will be a lot of events that will take place at these places around where the draft will actually take place. Like I mentioned, the actual draft will happen between First Energy Stadium and the Great Lakes Science Center, but things will also take place at the First Energy Stadium. Things will take place at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the Great Lakes Science Center. Things that fans can interact with, all types of activities, and just fun events. So it's not just a draft thing, it's like a whole major event, almost festival-like type of thing. But of course, they will adhere to safe protocols so that this draft and all of these events are ran smoothly with no further spread or anything like that. And usually the draft starts around like 8 p.m. on Thursday for the first day, round one. So expect the draft to start up somewhere around then. All of the events will be taking place before and afterwards, though. But before we really dive into some of the events, we need to talk about who can actually go. It's not just going to be everybody. So, as I previously mentioned, only invited guests and selected fans will be able to sit in the viewing zone of the main stage, but the general public will be able to attend the NFL Draft Experience theme park. Again, there's going to be a lot of things going on, so they're considering it a theme park. Now, of course, those who are looking to attend the draft will have to wear masks and follow social distancing protocols and guidelines. And of course, like any other safety protocols that are being implemented around the city for the 3-day period and events. And masks will be, of course, provided for those who need them, but I don't see how you would even just go there without a mask already ready. But if you need them, they will have that there. Of course, there's going to be a lot of hand sanitizing stations set up all over the event. And of course, not all of the players will be there. I mean, some players don't even accept the invitations, but then also, of course, they don't send invitations to all players. There's not enough room. So a select few players and their families, or like close people to them, will be there, like near the front, like the little special area with the tables and the seats and everything. But then every other player will participate virtually. I mean, now the good thing about having that virtual draft, even just outside of it was necessary for the situation we were in with COVID-19 and the pandemic, but also now that we've done an entire draft virtually, we can implement a lot of great virtual things and ideas to mix it in with the real life draft. So there will be more virtual involvement in this draft than any other drafts in previous history other than the completely virtual one. So I think this Cleveland one will set a nice precedent for how drafts should continue in the future. Even if COVID-19 isn't a thing at all, it's just nice to have some virtual aspects to it. to where players that aren't currently there are still heavily involved, and they can have their cameras at their houses and things like that. I mean, just like we started to do even before the fully virtual draft, but I'm pretty sure the draft in Cleveland, this 2021 draft, and further drafts will have a heavier virtual involvement. And of course, Roger Goodell will be on stage for the draft, so he'll be there. He said he's excited to get out of the basement where he spent the last draft year, and he'll be able to interact with the players and all of the fans in person. There will also be headlining acts that will perform each day on the main stage. Also, teams like coaches and front office staff, like for my Burgundy and Gold, Ron Rivera, Marty Herney, Martin Mayhew, Chris Polian, and all of those guys will also be involved in the draft and will be able to gather in a draft room at a location of their choosing while following appropriate protocols. So teams, coaches, and staffs more than likely will be in Cleveland, but they'll just be in separate areas around Cleveland. I mean, some people may even be like in hotel conference rooms or whatever. Now let's get into some of these activities that are also going on outside of the draft. Again, it's basically going to be an interactive theme park, and it'll actually be free and open to the public. You just have to adhere to all of the safety protocols and processes. But to manage the capacity to follow these said protocols and for it to not get out of control, if you want to attend the theme park, you will have to make a reservation on the NFL One Pass app ahead of time, which will be available to download the week of March 29th, so next week. So once that opens up, if you plan on attending, you better hurry up. One of the events at the draft will allow fans to go on to First Energy Stadium and attempt to kick field goals. Like I said earlier, there will also be a lot of performances on the main stage, so there will technically be concerts there as well. The fans in the inner circle will be chosen by each of the 32 clubs to serve as their draft ambassadors. So that's interesting. That means there will be an equal fan presence within like the draft where all of the cameras are at. Instead of it being like 80% Cleveland fans, it will actually be an even amount of fans from each team there. And it's really interesting that teams will be able to choose their guys, and the fact that they consider them draft ambassadors, that's really cool. I like that idea. But that's just a select few of fans. But the NFL said that there will be tens of thousands of people who will be able to participate in the overall draft experience. May not be in the front during the draft where all the cameras at, right behind the players, but again, tens of thousands. That's wild. I never thought we would get to this point this soon. The NFL also said they're working with restaurants around the city to create a taste of Cleveland that ties into the draft for those people who are looking for something to eat during the 3 days of the draft. The goal is to incorporate the entire downtown area into a draft experience. So again, the interactive theme park, they want the restaurants around the area to be involved. They want to be able to provide safe outdoor spaces to watch the draft, eat and drink at these said restaurants. So they want the city to be a massive extension of the draft. That actually sounds really fun. If I weren't afraid of COVID, I would definitely be out there. They want the whole downtown to be involved with it. Basically, everybody outside and enjoying themselves at the theme park or throughout all of the restaurants in the busy downtown area. Everybody, the whole area is straight draft for those few days. And of course, like NFL legends and current players will be at the draft starting on the second day of the draft to start announcing picks and things like that. And on the third day, NFL teams will be shown in their draft rooms making their decisions and also making the draft selection from their rooms. And it will be announced by owners or general managers or other appointed high-ranking members of the team. Maybe like Coach Rivera will say some of his picks. I don't know. But yeah, man, if you're not afraid of Corona like I am, and if you have an ability to get out there in Cleveland, I say definitely do it, because it sounds like a truly unique experience, and I feel like it's going to set the standard for how drafts should be ran from now on. It should be an entire city-like event, not just at the specific draft building or dome or stadium. It should be a collection of buildings, collection of streets, restaurants, and everybody involved and heavily invested into making this a great experience. I'm glad that there has been an official paradigm shift in how we telecast the draft and how we as fans attend and enjoy the draft and experience the draft. It's starting to turn into a thing where the draft isn't just the only big event that's going on. This is becoming an event that you can take your entire family to, your children to. You don't have to be just a football tryhard to want to be a part of the draft experience now. So again, I love this, and shouts out to Cleveland for being the first ones to spearhead and trailblaze this movement. And shouts out to the NFL for also collaborating with them and bouncing ideas off of each other and coming up with such a great event. But that's the end of this video. I just wanted to talk to y'all about how exactly the draft will go down, when it's going to happen, what it's going to look like and sound like and things like that. I'm mostly glad to finally have fans involved so we can finally hear the boos and the yeahs again. Because no draft is a real draft without Roger Goodell getting booed off rip. No draft is a draft without the Giants booing no matter which player they get. The fans being there definitely enhanced the experience for even us back here who are watching it through some sort of a screen. But yeah, man, that's the end of this video. Please like it if you liked it. If you learned anything, please subscribe if you haven't. Hit the bell next to the subscription button so you get notification every time I release a video like this one, these informative videos. Every time I release a video related to the draft, free agency, I'm coming out with film sessions, already working on the William Jackson film session. That will be the next one that comes out to y'all. Of course, channel members will get the more extended version. Non-channel members, the general public, will get the shortened version, maybe one play per point that I make. Like for William Jackson, I'll talk about his ability to press man, and I'll probably just show one clip for the general public, but for channel members who will get the exclusive longer extended version of the film session will probably see like 3 to 5 examples of how he can press man and things like that. So stay tuned for that. Stay tuned for 3 more mock drafts before this draft gets here. Stay tuned for all of the live streams every Friday 8 to 10 p.m. and every Sunday for a couple of hours at a random time, sometime in the afternoon. And yeah, man, I appreciate everybody that gives to the channel in every way. Shouts out to everybody that supports the channel by liking every video and stream, sharing it out to people to bring more people to the Street Scores family. Shouts out to everybody that donates to the channel. Big shouts out to all of my sponsors, my channel members, especially the Pro Bowl sponsors whose names you see scrolling on the screen right now, man. Big shouts out to all y'all, man. Really appreciate y'all. I'll catch y'all later. I'm working. I'm out.